and sphere. In mathematics, the sphere is the generalization of the ordinary sphere to spaces of arbitrary dimension. It is a dimensional manifold that can be embedded in Euclidean space. The zero sphere is a pair of points, the one sphere is a circle, and the two sphere is an ordinary sphere. Generally, when embedded in a dimensional Euclidean space, and sphere is the surface or boundary of a dimensional ball. That is, for any natural number, and sphere of radius may be defined in terms of an embedding in dimensional Euclidean space as the set of points that are at distance from a central point, where the radius may be any positive real number. Thus, the sphere would be defined by, in particular, an n-sphere embedded in n-dimensional Euclidean space is called a hypersphere. The sphere of unit radius is called the unit sphere, denoted, often referred to as the sphere. When embedded as described, n-sphere is the surface or boundary of n-dimensional ball. 4. The spheres are the simply connected dimensional manifolds of constant, positive curvature. The spheres admit several other topological descriptions, for example, they can be constructed by gluing two-dimensional Euclidean spaces together, by identifying the boundary of an cube with a point, or by forming the suspension of an sphere. For any natural number, an sphere of radius is defined as the set of points in dimensional Euclidean space that are at distance from some fixed point, where may be any positive real number and where may be any point in dimensional space. In particular, the set of points in space that define an sphere is represented by the equation where equals is a center point, and is the radius. The above sphere exists in dimensional Euclidean space and is an example of a manifold. The volume form of an sphere of radius is given by where is the Hodge star operator, see for a discussion and proof of this formula in the case. As a result, the space enclosed by an sphere is called an ball. An ball is closed if it includes the sphere, and it is open if it does not include the sphere. Specifically, topologically, and sphere can be constructed as a one-point compactification of dimensional Euclidean space. Briefly, the sphere can be described as, which is dimensional Euclidean space plus a single point representing infinity in all directions. In particular, if a single point is removed from a sphere, it becomes homeomorphic to. This forms the basis for stereographic projection. Div style equals overflow wrap, normal greater than in general, the volume of the ball in dimensional Euclidean space, and the surface area of the sphere in dimensional Euclidean space, of radius, are proportional to the th power of the radius. We write for the volume of the ball and for the surface area of the sphere, both of radius, where and are the values for the unit radius case dot div. Given the radius, the enclosed volume and the surface area of the sphere reach a maximum and then decrease towards zero as the dimension increases. In particular, the volume enclosed by the sphere of constant radius embedded in dimensions reaches a maximum at the dimension satisfying and where is given in the sidebar to the right. If the last inequality holds with equality, then the same maximum also occurs at. Specifically, for unit radius the largest enclosed volume is that enclosed by a four-dimensional sphere bounding a five-dimensional ball. Similarly, the surface area of the sphere of constant radius embedded in dimensions reaches a maximum for dimension that satisfies and where is given in sidebar to the right. If the last inequality holds with equality, then the same maximum also occurs at. Specifically, for unit radius the largest surface area occurs for the six-dimensional sphere bounding a seven-dimensional ball. The zero ball consists of a single point. The zero-dimensional Hausdorff measure is the number of points in a set. So, the unit 1 ball is the interval of length 2. So, the 0 sphere consists of its two endpoints. So, the unit 1 sphere is the unit circle in the Euclidean plane, and this has circumference. The region enclosed by the unit 1 sphere is the 2 ball, or unit disk, and this has area analogously. In 3-dimensional Euclidean space, the surface area of the unit 2 sphere is given by and the volume enclosed is the volume of the unit 3 ball, given by the surface area, or properly the dimensional volume, of the sphere at the boundary of the ball of radius is related to the volume of the ball by the differential equation or, equivalently, representing the unit ball as a union of concentric sphere shells, so. We can also represent the unit sphere as a union of tori, each the product of a circle with an sphere. Let and, so that and. Then, since, the equation holds for all. This completes our derivation of the recurrences. Combining the recurrences, we see that so it is simple to show by induction on K that, where denotes the double factorial, defined for odd integers by. In general, The volume, in dimensional Euclidean space, of the unit ball, is given by where is the gamma function, which satisfies, and by multiplying by, differentiating with respect to, and then setting, we get the closed form. The recurrences can be combined to give the reverse direction recurrence relation for surface area, as depicted in the diagram. Index shifting to then yields the recurrence relations. Where, and the recurrence relation for can also be proved via integration with two-dimensional polar coordinates. We may define a coordinate system in n-dimensional Euclidean space which is analogous to the spherical coordinate system defined for three-dimensional Euclidean space, in which the coordinates consist of a radial coordinate and angular coordinates, where the angles range over radians and ranges over radians. If R the Cartesian coordinates, then we may compute from width. Except in the special cases described below, the inverse transformation is unique. Where if for some but all of R 0 then when, and when. There are some special cases where the inverse transform is not unique, for any will be ambiguous whenever all of R 0, in this case may be chosen to be 0. Expressing the angular measures in radians, the volume element in dimensional Euclidean space will be found from the Jacobian of the transformation. And the above equation for the volume of the ball can be recovered by integrating the volume element of the sphere, which generalizes the area element of the two-sphere, is given by the natural choice of an orthogonal basis over the angular coordinates is a product of ultraspherical polynomials. 4. And the for the angle in concordance with the spherical harmonics. Just as a two-dimensional sphere embedded in three dimensions can be mapped onto a two-dimensional plane by a stereographic projection, and sphere can be mapped onto a dimensional hyperplane by the dimensional version of the stereographic projection. For example, the point on a two-dimensional sphere of radius 1 maps to the point on the plane. In other words, likewise, the stereographic projection of a sphere of radius 1 will map to the dimensional hyperplane perpendicular to the axis as to generate uniformly distributed random points on the unit sphere, gives the following algorithm. Generate a dimensional vector of normal deviates. Now calculate the radius of this point. The vector is uniformly distributed over the surface of the unit ball. An alternative given by Marsalia is to uniformly randomly select a point in the unit cube by sampling each independently from the uniform distribution over, computing as above, and rejecting the point and resampling if, and when a point in the ball is obtained scaling it up to the spherical surface by the factor, then again is uniformly distributed over the surface of the unit ball. With a point selected uniformly at random from the surface of the unit sphere, one needs only a radius to obtain a point uniformly at random from within the unit ball. If is a number generated uniformly at random from the interval and is a point selected uniformly at random from the unit sphere, then is uniformly distributed within the unit ball. Alternatively, points may be sampled uniformly from within the unit ball by a reduction from the unit sphere. In particular, if is a point selected uniformly from the unit sphere, then is uniformly distributed within the unit ball. Note that if it's sufficiently large, most of the volume of the ball will be contained in the region very close to its surface, so a point selected from that volume will also probably be close to the surface. This is one of the phenomena leading to the so-called curse of dimensionality that arises in some numerical and other applications. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.